description is of two authors. The left one is my colleague, and yesterday I combined, originally decided to he used to be the presenter of the second speech. Anyway, he is a university CEO, like we say, rector. He is doctor of science as well. He has great experience in the ship construction subject. Before his position today, he used to be vice president of university in research. So it's a bit closer to my position today. Definitely I'm not vice president, but look like. And he used to be, and today he is university president. And we have very close subject of the research. We say the optimization from the economical criteria of the merchant ship for construction of new projects, something like that. And our presentation in general, if we combine two into unit one, can be like a determination of project characteristics of merchant ships using economic criteria, objective functions, and the concept of systemic approach. We listened yesterday about the goals and aims of the conference, of this symposium, like World Ocean Symposium, and the main goal is meeting the market demand of scientific researchers and the meeting of the people and the participation of other countries and their partnership, something like that, and the introducing of new goals into the Qingdao industry. That is all probably corresponds to the methodology of the using economical criteria functions for determination of ship project characteristics. And besides, one more remark is about difference of Russian and Chinese approaches to ship construction. China today is a very good developed country and very good in the industrial aspect and traditional industry, like our session is all kind of industries, as I understand it, all kinds is very traditional for China. And China as well has a very good developed shipbuilding industry of merchant ship of the great tonnages. We can say there is maybe three countries in the world, like China, Korea, and Japan, number one in tonnage output of the cargo ship. Maybe there is some countries like United States, maybe like Russia, former Soviet Union, of the construction of combat ships. But exactly about, while talking about the merchant ships, number one in the world today is countries from Asia like China and like Korea and Japan. But some other countries have their own interest in the development of ship construction, such as countries of maybe North America, I mean Canada, probably you find that I am as well the member of Canadian Institute of Marine Engineers, and Russia too. These two countries have the interest to access to the marine resources from the Arctic seas. And there is a local demand for construction of ships for Arctic exploitation in the icy seas. And maybe there will be the partnership between Russia, between such countries like North America, Canada, in construction of merchant ships. But if we have the close understanding what is the ships, what ships required for local demands in North America, in Russia, and so on, and that can be contracts for Chinese industry. In Russia is a strategy of development of shipbuilding industry. The strategy decided that there is three shipbuilding centers. One center is center in west of Russia, in European part of Russia. The center is in St. Petersburg, and some cities nearby St. Petersburg as well. In this center includes one shipyard from Finland, 100% of property bought by Russian government. Second place is the north center of shipbuilding in Russia is for construction of ships for navigation in the Arctic seas. And the is the far east center of ship construction, local here to China, is where I am from, from University in Vladivostok is closed here to China. It's very close from Vladivostok to China, 100 kilometers there only. And there is Far Eastern. Far Eastern is in Russia, Far East, center of ship construction. And this ship construction center of Russian Far East and Pacific Coast is aimed to construct merchant ships. And our university involved in the processes of the development of ship construction in accordance with this strategy of the development of ship construction. And what about the countries, if not only Russia? I can say a bit about North America. I researched about North America. There is in Canada a strategy of the development of ship construction as well. The Canadian strategy, we say National Canadian Shipbuilding Procurement Strategy. The strategy in Canada is aimed to construct the ships, maybe some close to the same classes as in Russian strategy of the development. In Canada, the total amount of money spent by the government is around $33 billion of dollar Canadian spent for two places. In Canada, one place is construction aimed to construct the ships in the Atlantic coast. In the Atlantic coast, there is Galifax city. In Galifax, there is shipyards of company, so-called Irwin Shipbuilding Company in Galifax. And the second place of the investments of money in Canada is Pacific Coast, closing maybe to here, British Columbia, Vancouver, Victoria, the cities close to Pacific Coast. In these cities is shipyards, we say span shipyards. Span shipyards consist of three shipyards, one shipyard located in Victoria shipyards, and two shipyards is in Vancouver, is Vancouver Dry Docks and Vancouver Shipyards. And total amount of money, I said that like 33 billion of Canadian dollars shared, and maybe three quarters spent into the Atlantic coast to construction of the combat ships, combat vessels, and one fourth part spent on the Pacific coast for construction of merchant ships. And these ships is as well, maybe the same as in Russia, which is the similarity of the strategies for construction of ships for the Arctic seas and North Oceans. And universities usually involved in the processes of construction and determination of methodology, how to determine the characteristics of ship which will satisfy the market demand. As our university, the same in universities in Canada, I sometimes keep the relations with people from Canada, from Victoria and from Vancouver, University of British Columbia. They deals in the development of the methodology how to determine the characteristics of ship to make the reasonable project. So let me please say a bit about the contents of our presentation. I mean our, because it's presentation of two people, my alter author, Professor Sergei Agai, and mine. The contents is the about the use of systemic approach and objective functions, the relevance of systemic design approaches, the terminology, I will talk what is the key words, physical assumptions for determining of the ship particulars. Historically, ship particulars, we need to construct ship to know the sizes of ship. Historically, maybe hundreds of years ago, 150, the particulars decided using the prototypes. Prototypes is analogies which more close and successful than before. The dependencies of projected ship particulars on each characteristics is much closer to nowadays methodology. Next, methodological obstacles of the old-fashioned design approaches. Sometimes when we use the prototypes, it's not the best way to design ship. Maybe there are obstacles and any kind of the deficiencies, shortcomings can be. We have to use economic criteria to meet the market demand. So the next is economic criteria on cost minimizing for using merchant ship project optimization. So there can be economic approaches. We can find the best ship from the point of view of the minimal cost of construction or minimal cost of each operation. Or we can determine the characteristics of ship for the maximal profit of each operation. And next will be some samples. Samples of use of the economical criterions for determination of ship characteristics. Criterion economical, this is economical concepts of required freight rate of, and profitability criterions like internal rate of return. This all is the terms we say about the economical appreciation of the ship project option. This is we use economical criterion. Sometimes we can determine the ship characteristic in the broad sense. In the broad sense, we mean that not only for ship construction, but also for buying ship on the second-hand market, for the purchase of ship. It can be some additional risks for that. And there could be one more economical criterion, like net present value. Net present value is widely used for determination. Maybe it is today one of the more logical economical criterions, because it is in maximal degree released from the any obstacles which characteristic for the other criterions, like costs and so on. And the next criterion is, in next articles of today's presentation, will be possibilities of project optimization criteria use which have not been defined by economical indexes. So some people can determine the characteristics of ship which correspond of the minimal mass or maximal propulsive factor of ship, or any other characteristic of ship which do not express it in the, like, economical index in money or in percent and so on. So is it logical to determine ship which you have of the minimal displacement for unit of cargo carried? I don't know about it, but there is some positivity, there is obstacles as well. And besides, there could be the generalized criterion use. The samples will be two. And there could be the logical contradictions inside the objective functions. When we minimize it, we can tend the objective functions, economical criteria for choice of the project characteristics of ship into two groups. One criterion is the criterion of the choice, which close correspond to the minimized costs, like the best ship is, which is the cheapest one. And the second part of the criterion could be like a criterion which correspond to the maximal profit. The best ship is which correspond with the maximal profit. But each of two groups of criterion corresponds with the obstacles. We will talk about it a bit. Next, important is the introduction of the systemic approach. So we have to make a comparison of options if we use economical criteria to make a choice. For example, you have a definite amount of money, maybe 100 million American dollars, and you need to decide what to spend these dollars. You decide first that you would spend in construction of ship. The next question you meet is what the ship you would build. Well, probably it will be one ship for 400 million of dollars, or maybe there will be two ships for 50 million dollars each. So the decision of size and the decision of what to ship to build, or maybe many ships of small size, I don't know about that, but this is, we meet the concept of the comparability. So if we say about the best ship is, which is the cheapest one, so can we compare the ship of big size and the small one? Exactly, the cheaper is the small one, but probably there will be restrictions for the comparison. These restrictions depends on the systemic approach we will talk about. And systemic approach leads us to hierarchy of models. There can be model of ship optimization, model of ship subsystem optimization. This depends on systemic approach too. And there will be some conclusions and the samples of use of systemic approach for determination what is the ship characteristics, what is particulars. So first let me please very brief about the concepts, about the terms we used. What we say mean the design process. We say the design process what aim to, the subject of merchant ship design. We say that design is the determination of characteristics and particulars of ships and subsystems. Ship subsystems to construct the ship. And the second reason for design is the design is the process of drafts and all information for ship construction technology. So I will say about the use of the economics for determination of ship characteristics for construction, and in the next determination of ship particulars, and the next use it for development of documentation for the processes of ship design. And the keywords will have like ship characteristics and particulars. And in the next, I will talk more systematic what is characteristics, what particulars we use. But first of all, let me please, just like a sample, advice that probably the characteristics can be, like here we have displacement, dead weight. This is samples of which is the ship characteristics. A cargo, tonnage, gross tonnage, net tonnage, capacity of ship hulls, velocity and effective power of ship main engine. This is characteristics. And the second line is the samples of the particulars. Particles is the ship length of the water line, ship beam, ship depth. And the next is block coefficient and draft of ship and so on. Or their proportion. Proportions like a proportion of beam to draft, for example, and the proportion of depth to draft to, of length to, and so on. Finally, to construct ship, exactly, we need the particulars. We don't need the characteristics, because characteristics is just an intermediate concept to determine the particulars in the next. We need to construct a ship. And originally, a bit, a couple of words about the history. Originally, particulars of ships were determined using the prototypes. And maybe later, like 100 years ago, 150 years ago, physical properties of ship were used for determination of particulars while designing of ship. And the physical properties of ship in the more general state would be considered as the external properties physical of ship and the internal properties. External properties, we say, the physical properties of ship in interaction with the ocean environment. We have the samples of the external property of ship, like stability, propulsion, controllability, insubmersibility. So maybe 100-150 years ago was developed the ship theory. Ship theory is the physics about physical properties of ship. You can determine any of the physical properties of ship if you set ship characteristics. So if you set displacement of ship sizes, you can determine what is the characteristics of propulsion, stability, buoyancy, and so on. But we need to have decision of the opposite tasks. Because the subject of ship design is determination of ship characteristics, independence on physical properties, independence on the economical properties of ship. And these two people here is Russian professors. They worked maybe 50 years ago, they developed the concepts of ship design. We use it today. Is a classical concept in Russia from behalf of a physical point of view. So if you would like to determine the ship, which definitely will have the buoyancy, the very appropriate buoyancy, the stability, the good propulsion, very good water resistance on, and you need to determine the ship characteristics which satisfy beforehand these physical properties of ship in future. These professors, the left one is Professor Leo Nogget, and the second one, Professor Viktor Ashik, worked in St. Petersburg in Russia. And Leo Nogget passed on 1972, Viktor Ashik passed on 1985. I used to be just a student in those times, so I'm not knew them personally. So just I know these people because I learned textbooks of them when I was a young student and the young scientist and the next. These two persons as well, professors, the left one was my teacher, doctorate teacher when I was doctorate student, Professor Alvian Vashechenko, and Professor Boris Tsarev worked in St. Petersburg in Russia. And these people was doctorate students before of Professor Ashik, the right one person. This was two doctorate students. And I was the doctoral student of the left one. And these people developed the concepts of determination of ship characteristics and particulars, independence on physical approaches. So if you said that the ship would be buoyant, would be insubmersible, would be of very good propulsion, would be of very good hydrodynamical properties, strong and so on, And what you have to set the particulars to determine beforehand. So is this opposite task to the physical one? These people developed this task. And we have the list of particulars of ship in the proportional appreciation, such as we have dependence of beam ratio to draft. It's characterized by the physical property of stability. The second is the proportion of depth to draft. It depends on property of insubmersibility. And in the last page part of this presentation of this slide, you can see the sample how determine these proportions, taking these physical properties of ship for the sample of the oil tanker. So we have here. Besides to determine ship particulars like sizes, we use the Archimedes law is on slide, on the upper part of the slide, and besides we use the so-called the displacement equation, displacement balance equation. Here is the samples of the displacement balance equation in the slide. But when we use each all was about the history. When we use the analogies for determination of ship characteristics, we meet the methodological obstacles. What is the obstacle? The first obstacle can be that if it is of the little use, use of the prototype, is of the little use for design of innovative merchant ship for which there are no close prototypes. So if you need to construct a new ship of new class, probably we do not have the prototype. At the same time, the design of innovative merchant ships is of the greatest professional interest for shipyards and design bureaus. So definitely we need to design the new ships with the lack of the prototypes and analogies to design. And from the economic point of view, the innovative merchant ships as the objects of investing in the construction is the most degree characterized value added. So as for aims of this Congress, we need to meet the market demand, we have to talk about the design of ships with the maximal satisfaction of economics and market demand. That is, we have to use economical approaches, but if we use the analogies, we do not have ship of new classes of the best economical performances. That is because this is obstacle of using prototypes for design, and we need to find the approaches of ship design without using of prototypes and the physical characteristics of prototypes. And the second obstacle is that the use of prototype design characteristic of new ship projecting is very conservative and does not reflect the impact of economic conditions on the performance of design ship. That is, projecting ship new may contain undesirable differences of the prototype using. So the same differences which were characteristic for the prototype remains for ship constructed using the prototype too. That is why we have to use the economic criteria, and could be the economic criteria on first on cost minimizing for use in merchant ship project optimizing. For investments planning for the marine industrial activity is required the determination of the optimum project characteristics of merchant ships using the economic criteria for any contract to purchase or to contract new. So for if we need to purchase ship on the second-hand market, but we have the restriction of money, we need to make a spending of money for investment for the best ship, we have to use the economic criteria to make a choice, which is the best option to buy or to construct the new. And there is a sample of the objective function. It looks very complex, but it's not so complex practically. Practically, this mathematical equation used with Excel tables. And used Excel tables is not so complex. This is an objective function. It consists of summons. The summons is, the objective function is like minimized costs. It consists of annual costs of ship operation, the costs of the first investment in ship construction or bought on the second-hand market, and the costs for the supply of the working assets. So we need some money to have with the ship to operate and navigate, so this working assets. And the sum of these indexes characterized as objective function of minimizing discounted costs. And the best ship is which satisfied the minimal meaning of this cost. It's important that For the objective function, all of summons, like annual costs, like investments, like working assets, all summons is functional dependencies. The functional dependencies on variables, on parameters, on data. And as well as the summons are dependencies on variables, parameter, and data, the objective function as well is dependent on variables, parameter, and data too. And it's important what is the variables, what data, what is the parameter. Usually when we optimize SHIP as a project, the variables are SHIP project characteristics searching while optimizing. And parameters is SHIP project particular, so SHIP subsystem characteristics. There is many, very many characteristics of SHIP design. Finally, we have to determine exactly particulars, because to make the technological documentation for shipyard to construct ship, we need to make drafts. To have the drafts, we need to make to determine the sizes of ship, such as length, beam, draft, and so on. And to this, the sizes is particulars. But originally, we have to determine the characteristics, like characteristics are displacement, dead weight, cargo, tonnage, power, velocity. So we don't need characteristics to make a draft, but we have to determine them first. And that means the constraints. So each of the optimizing corresponds with the constraints. We suppose that all options of SHIP compared by this one criterion, maybe of discounted costs for the search of the minimal costs, all options which varied by characteristics of variables, but they are comparable. Comparable options mean that for each of the options is the same constraints. Constraints is data. We say that. To simplify this mathematical equation, in the next we just omit these all symbols of variables. Nevertheless, in all the next functions is dependencies on variables, parameters, and data, despite the fact that we omit these symbols in the formula, such as this formula number one is the same one as the previous one, but we just omit the variables, parameters, and data, like constraints. This formula is the same as the previous one. This is a formula of economical objective function of determination what is the costs of ship operation. And we can use it as a mathematical model for determination of the project particulars and characteristics of SHIP. But we can keep simplifying this formula, because we would like to find it a more simple performance. We would use the assumptions. The assumption can be that for the first step of SHIP design, just only for the step of SHIP construction, there is then we could assume that probably the T is characteristics of time of leaving of ship before withdrawal into scrap, before the utilization of ship. This time is very long, and using this like maybe 20 years, maybe 18, maybe 25, don't know how many years is time of leaving of ship. But anyway, we can define T like infinitive. It makes us possible to simplify this mathematical equation, because difference in this appreciation of the subjective functions, taking into account the time of living of ship, like 25 years and infinite time, is not about the same appreciation of the objective function. This is the second one assumption. Second one is we take the summons here in this equation as the constants, do not vary in time. It makes us possible to keep simplifying of this formula one, and we define finally the very simple formula, look like that the discount cost, the economical criteria of SHIP determination characteristics at the step of project determination. The formula is that very simple. It consists of three summons. First summons is annual costs of operation, the investments into SHIP construction, and investments into supply of the working assets. And we can use this formula in the next for determination of the SHIP characteristics. If we will determine each of summand in the formula, independence on ship characteristic variable like x, like parameters y, and like constants z. And this formula about the same as the previous one, last here on the slide downstairs, and the next one here is another performance of the formula. Just we show that each of summons depends on ship characteristic search. We need to determine what ship size to build, the big one, and what is the power of the main engine of ship. That is the formula of this, about the same one. Besides, we can determine these costs minimized for one unit of effect, because we have to compare ships of different various sizes. And when systemic concepts of absorption comparability are observed, the criterion function can be applied for the project optimization of ship in the form of specific discounted cost per one unit of the effect. So effect is characteristic of physical work ship per year. It can be a characteristic of annual cargo turnover, how many cargoes carried per year, or maybe effect is characteristic of the fish catch, how many fish catch per year. So we can determine this objective function for one unit of the effect. And this objective function we use independence of each summon to ship characteristics, like sizes and the power of the main engine. And in the next, if we set all summoned in this previous formula, the last one on the slide, if we set mathematical expression independence on ship sizes, like dead weight is how many cargo and fuel can be on board ship, on power, and on annual turnover effect, like Q here, or maybe annual catch effect too, if we say about the fish catching boat, so we can disclose the objective function. So we define finally, it's not just simple one expression like the last one on slide here, downstairs on the right. But here we can disclose, it's not so simple. Anyway, we say this is a basic economical model. Basic economical, that is the most simple model, which nevertheless contains the account of x, y, z, contains account of the arguments, account of search variable, contains account of the particulars like parameters, y, and contains account of the constraints like data set z. And finally, and we can determine this objective function, which here we have the expression disclosed. We can determine this like a graphic, like graph for the as a sample of determination of the merchant ship. Here is a sample of the fishing vessel, fish catch for industrial fishing vessel characteristic. You can find on the picture the surface. The surface is the objective function. The arguments on the horizontal plane, we have two axes. This is the main engine power, and the second axis is the dead weight. And we can determine this objective function because this is the costs, discounted costs. The best ship is those which one corresponds for the minimal amount of costs spent for catch of 1 ton of fish. So how much can minimal be spent for catching of 1 ton of, I don't know, but what kind of fish, what species, maybe like pollock in the sea or herring in the sea, what any kind of ship. And we can find that if the ship characteristic project will be between here like 500 to 700 ton dead weight, and the power will be between, I don't know, for the minimal characteristic of the criterion function. Criterion function and objective function, we say the same, this like synonyms. And the power will be between, I don't know, maybe 2000 and 3000 kilowatt. The ship characteristic is the best for catch of ships because it corresponds for the minimal characteristic of criterion function. And this criterion function is minimized. And we find the area of characteristics of ship. And if Russians will ask of Chinese, please construct the ships for industrial fishing. What characteristics of ships would the Russians, for example, Russians, maybe not Russians, maybe Canadians, maybe I don't know, North Americans, Europeans, what characteristics of ship they will inquire? What they will do this all derivations and finally goes with the assumptions to the criterion functions and find this surface and find this area which correspond to the minimal amount of criterion function, minimal characteristic, and find that probably the minimal cost for catching fish of this definite species is $0.45,000 per one ton. So how much costs maybe pollock wholesale on the market? I don't know how much costs, but maybe $1,500 per one ton of pollock frost in the wholesale market. So if the costs of each catch from the ocean minimal for the effective characteristic of ship is about 0.45, that is the profit is $1,500 for one ton of fish catch minus the expenses. The profit is about $1,000 per one ton of fish catch of definite one species of fish. And this surface of the objective function is the same one that was here. So this function just performed here on the picture. And taking into account the definite assumptions for determination of ship characteristics. That is maybe a new one approach for determination of ship characteristics. As I talked originally, the old-fashioned way to determine ship characteristics is the use of the analogies. So we can find the fish boat of the most beneficial, as we decide about that, project, and we can ask it of ship construction company to construct the same one. Probably it would be the good idea if we have no the way to use the objective function, because the new one ship will probably remain the same obstacles, the same shortcomings, deficiencies, which is characteristic for the analog. And this is a sample of the criterion function of oil tanker, the same one as we have here for the same one conceptually. Exactly, we have for tanker, oil tanker, another one mathematical equation. Maybe another complex, maybe another characteristics, another sequence of use of the indexes in this equation of the objective function. But conceptually, the same approach. This is the determination of the operational speed, one axis of the horizontal plane, and the dead weight of oil tanker, using the objective function of minimizing costs. Yes, and we can to find here as well the area of the characteristics. So the tanker for the characteristics of the cargo traffic line set. We have to set what is the distance between harbors. If we do that and other characteristics we set, for the definite one circumstances, we can determine the characteristics of the oil tanker. Like here we have the optimal speed between maybe 11 to 15 knots. Optimal sizes, characteristic sizes is here for this sample dead weight. Optimal sizes is between 6 or maybe 15,000 ton of dead weight. Exactly, we can use for more exact determination another approaches to do that. And it is a sample of use the objective function, not for determination of new constructed ship characteristics, but to determine the characteristics of ship for purchase on the second-hand market. So we can use the same approach too for determination of the second-hand market. And yes, we can find here what is optimal velocity of ship and what is the dead weight of ship to buy on the second-hand market using the same objective function. And I would like to put your attention that the objective function we use it for the determination of ship characteristics depends on the combination of the economical indexes. So each of the objective functions we used before, like discounted costs here for the samples of determination characteristics of fish boats or characteristics of oil tanker. And all other classes of ships consists the objective functions of three main indexes. First index is income, second index is operation cost annual, and the third index is the construction costs, reproduction costs, how much we have to spend. And these all indexes are dependencies on characteristics of ship, like displacement, dead weight, cargo, tonnage. Some of these characteristics are dependent, but we use only for the objective functions the independent characteristics. If we have dependent, so first we have to determine the dependent on behalf of independent ones. And next we use it in the objective functions. And finally, we use these characteristics to set. If we want to find the ship particulars, we need finally because we need to develop the drafts and we develop the technological documentation for ship construction. For the documentation and for drafts, we need exactly particulars, like a ship length, like ship beam, like ship height or draft, I'm sorry, depth, like block coefficient, like draft, and so on. And there would be the mathematical sense of the indexes and the criterion functions, because the basic indexes in themselves, the basic indexes is in the each of the objective functions, is income, is annual costs of operation of ship, is construction costs. These indexes themselves do not reflect the critical judgment suited for choice of the optimal results. For example, it's not possible to determine whether it is necessary to reduce operation cost or not, since it depends on how index of income thus will change. These economic indexes are interdependent, so each of them cannot be used as the economical criteria, because we don't know what we have to do, the minimized cost. Probably not, because the minimization of costs correlates into the minimization of the incomes. So only the mathematical correlations of the basic economical indexes, like income, like annual cost, and like construction costs, here we say IC and RC, only the mathematical operations over these indexes bring us the mathematical judgments, the critical judgments suitable for use into the optimizing and to make a choice of project characteristic optimal from the point of view, like this one, for example. Yeah, okay. And besides, one more remark, if we cannot only use we use sometimes the economical appreciation, we say discounting is a correlation of the money spent in the different time for the present time. We have to correspond all expenses and all incomes spent for the present appreciation. To do that, we use usually the discounting. To make discounting, we use the factor of 1 plus I. I is a characteristic of the commercial risks. Is a, we say, discount rate. And all previous objective functions I talked about was on the basis of usual discounting, like here, in the first equation we have. We divide into factor 1 plus y in the power t, and so on. But we can make another mathematical operation of the discounting, like here we advise it to use the Euler number, this Euler number exponent. And with mathematically it's about the same as use the discounting. So in the next, the objective functions in the samples I will show contains as usual discounting by the factor 1 plus I, characteristics of commercial risks. So as
sorry to interrupt you, just for your information, as the chairman, your co-chair is not going to make it to the English Julia paper. Mm-hmm. Okay. And you can have the next slot to carry on with your presentation.
Okay. He will not be here.
He will not be here. He will not be here. Sorry. I can only apologize on his behalf.
I'm sorry for him, yes.
For
this session begin, I just talked a bit about that. Unfortunately, we had no second presenter. Second presenter is Dr.
You carry on. I probably will inform the organizer of the conference. Okay, you carry on.
Okay. And that is because today, before the coffee break, we don't have one presenter. That is, I present my speech on behalf of my, and the second speech today we have of my alter author, Dr. Sergei Agai. I present the speeches of two people. I combined it to unit one. And probably I can use the time of the second one speaker as he is absent today. And late, next will be Mr. Nicholas Carlson for the next presentation. Today he is a fourth number because of the absence of other person. That is, I keep talking about my presentation on behalf of mine and the second presenter, Dr. Sergei Agai. We have the close ones. And second sample of an objective function of the required freight rate. In practical shipping, sometimes we have the economical criteria like a required freight rate. But this is explaining that if we use an objective function like economic criterion of the required freight rate, we can gradually define that is mathematically the same as discounted costs. So some of economical criterions, while differs with the titles, could be mathematically the same. That is just a sample on this slide, this one criterion of the required freight rate, widely used in the shipping, corresponds to the same criterion like the second one or previous one, we say discounted costs criterion, the objective function we used for determination of ship characteristics. So it, we can say that it's not discounted cost objective function, but probably this is the required freight rate objective function. And besides of the use of costs as the criterion of ship optimality, we can use income and profit. This is a second sample. Optimality criteria of merchant ship project characteristics based on an estimation of project profitability indexes, the objective function of the internal rate of return. So we define the internal rate of return using incomes. The previous criterion do not contain the concept of the income. Here we have. It looks very complex as the previous one. Next we can simplify this mathematical equation. Usually practically using the Excel tables, it's not so complex. We can use Excel tables for determination of this one criterion. We can make simplification and after some assumptions like regard the constant in time of annual costs and like regard the independence on the time of ships leaving because of a very long period which not is so much important for the time of ship construction project. We can simplify this criterion of the profitability of internal rate of return is used in economics. Come to question number 6. This is very simple, much more simple than the previous one, number 4. But methodologically the same, number 6. And we can determine this objective function as a graph of dependence. The previous graphs was shown like we make a choice of the best ship characteristics using the minimized costs. Here we have the maximized internal rate of return. So if we use as a objective functions as a criterions the indexes of income, so the best ship is which correspond to the maximal appreciation of the objective function. On the picture we can see that the best ship probably is those which correspond the this efficient boat, which the best characteristic is the maximal corresponds to the internal rate of return like around 25%. It the index very close to the rentability, like a profit to investments with some deductions. And we can determine that the main engine have to be in between 1,250 power to maybe 2,500 of main engine kilowatt have to be. And I don't know how much is that weight because here's a picture of the ship. But definitely we can use this picture for determination of characteristics of ships for industrial fishing. And the second opinion of Russian, if you offer the supply on behalf of a shipyard in China here, you offer, please, we can, for Russian. Russians has very good fishing grounds in the North Ocean. There is many fish. Russians need new constructed fishing boats, and they will come to Chinese shipyard and ask, would you please construct us a ship? And you say yes, but you would please know what is the appreciation of Russians about the ship characteristics. From what behalf point of view Russians will do. This is the same, the criterion of merchant ship project characteristics on the basis of internal rate of return. This is a sample of the objective function, but not for the fishing boat. This is for oil tanker, for new constructed oil tanker, and this one is the same, but for the boat of tanker on the second-hand market for the forecast. But while investing in the second-hand market, we have to decide about the additional risks of investing in the second-hand market. And it should be specified. The strategic planning usually aimed at the reducing of risks. It's very, very riskful to buy the ship on the second-hand market. In conditions, it would be specified the strategic planning usually aimed at reducing of risks in conditions when the basic branch activity involves commercial risk. So as your company usually worked to buy the ships on the second-hand market, some staff of the company's managers have good experience and can improve the economical performance of the company using the regular basis bought ships on the second-hand market, but anyway, they would expand the profits of the company maybe for reducing of risks. So another kind of activity have to be the companies which regularly bought the ship on the second-hand market usually had to have the two activities. Second activity is investing in the ship construction, which is a very less riskful investments. And the function of the internal rate of return in the object is if no unit ship, but the sequence of replenishment and ship utilizing. Sometimes we can consider the object of the optimizing, not the ship itself, but the sequence. Like ship constructions, ship design, ship construction, ship operation, ship withdrawal. The replenishment means design, construction, and repetition many times of this cycle. And we need to deduct from the operation income definite amount each of the year for capitalization in the investments to renew this cycle many, many times. To do that, we develop another option of the projective function. This is the same objective function of the internal rate of return. So like interest rate with the account of their some assumptions. But not for the ship, as the previous one was on the pictures and in the formulas, like formula number 4. But this is the sample of the objective function for the sequence. If we consider the object of the optimizer, not ship itself, but sequence of ship design, construction, practical navigation, operation, and useful from the economical basis, and withdrawal and utilization for scrap, and repetition of this cycle many times. So the criterion function can be like here on the picture number 7. And usually we can use one more objective function on the basis on the criterion on the net present value. It's a very interesting criterion because it close corresponds with the concepts of safe and reasonable use of the ocean resources. The characteristics of the net present value. The best ship is which correspond to the maximal appreciation of the net present value. Net present value is if you construct a ship, you spend definite money, probably you spend $50 million of United States, and after that your ship valued maybe $100 million. So difference can be appreciated like a net present value. The best ship is which correspond to the maximal net present value appreciation like an objective function. This is a sample of the objective function. As well, it consists of summons. Summons is like income, annual operation costs, the refund in the last year for sale and ship maybe for the scrape like utilization, and the investments like for ship to buy and to supply of the working assets. This is the formula. It can be simplified using the assumptions, and finally, we have the objective function like this graph, and we can find that the best ship, here sample for fishing boat as well, corresponds with the point of the maximal meaning of criterion function of the net present value. This corresponds to ship power like 2000 kilowatt and ship dead weight of fish catching ship like about 100, maybe 1500 of ton dead weight. And this is an improvement of the net present value objective function using the Euler number here, like we say about that. And second remark, the next remark is, do we can have the objective function which have not been defined by economic indexes? Here we have some samples. As possibility of use for characteristics optimization of the criteria which have not been defined by economic indexes, we can say about some samples. What can be the criteria not only economical? The criterion can be the criteria of minimized, for example, minimized weight of ship structure, maybe yes, one criteria. Second could be minimized displacement for definite set dead weight, for example, or cargo. The maximized cargo capacity or tonnage, the operational speed can be the fastest ship probably we decide is the best one. The propulsive factor can be the criterion, traffic capacity and so on. It would be noted that applicability of this or such criteria would be estimated from the positions of conformity of characteristics optimization using this criteria which have not been defined by economical indexes. And the results optimization by a certain economic criterion. Probably if we do not, if we neglect economical criterion and if we use the criterion which is a physical or technical characteristic like these samples, we can meet the contradiction or the obstacle. For example, if we can use an unacceptable recommendation that can appear result to make the hull of the excessively expensive material, those light and strong. So, from the criterion which not characterized by economical index, like maybe the criteria of minimizing weight of ship structure, we can decide that the best ship is constructed of titanium or of carbon fiberglass plastic, like that. This is unusually accessible, expensive ships, so we had to have the more general economical criterion to make a choice about this definite one, which not expressed economically, to decide do we can use the criterion of the minimal mass of ship hull, for example. And for use of optimality criterion, which not an economic index, they're supposed to be the general economic criterion which relation it in each. It's possible to judge about applicability of not economic criterion. And if we need to have at least one more criterion, not physical but economical, to decide about physical criterion, probably the question arises, do we need to have a physical criterion of the optimality of ship characteristics if at least we need to have one economical criterion to decide about this one physical? Probably we don't need to do that, and that is not of the great sense. Next sample of the objective function which generalized of two criteria, the internal rate of return and the present net present value. Previously we talked a bit about the criterion economical of the internal rate of return, like using the indexes of incomes and the net present value of ship, which close correspond to the concepts of safe use of the ocean resources. Can we combine these two criterions into unit one? Sometimes yes, if we make any transformation with the each of two criterions combined into unit one. We do here we have the sample of the combining of internal rate of return, this criterion talked about before, very complex formula, but easy to use, and we had the graphic presentation too. And the second part is net present value. We transformed into the comparable with the first one part. And finally, we can use it for determination of the fishing boat characteristics. So, on the picture, we have dependencies on displacement of ship, of fish boat, the characteristics of the internal rate of return, the this one characteristics, like this one symbol characterizing the ratio of the net present value to the investments. This is the second one. And the, finally, we come to this complex criterion, like this complex criterion is, and we can decide about the characteristics of ship using this complex criterion as a combination of two entered criterion of net present value and the internal rate of return. This is about the same, but for use for the ship on the second-hand market, we may, can make a choice about what age of vessel to buy. If you want to buy new, not new vessel, but from the second-hand market, probably we can buy using the economic criteria of two combined criterions like internal rate of return and net present value. Here we can do and define that reasonable is to buy the ship for the all circumstances set, like of the age around 25 years maybe. And this is a sample of use of this generalized criterion, this one, for determination of characteristics of ferry. This is a practical task we developed for one shipping company operates in the Pacific Coast in Russia, in Vladivostok. They had some money and they wanted to invest in the ship for operation between Russia and Korea. They asked it, and we decided using this economical criteria what to make a choice. We concern different classes of ships. All ferries exactly, yes, but one of them are fast speed ferry. This is automobile ferry, this is usual ferry, a new, this is second hand. And we decided, and they finally bought the first one. Today it operates between Vladivostok and South Korea. Unfortunately, they hadn't enough money to build a new one. But anyway, the objective function of generalizing criterion like that one, was useful to decide this task of determination of the characteristics. So characteristics can be not only the sizes of ship, it can be the class of ship, because these ships of other classes. The same can be the age of ship, could be no, new one or second hand and so on. And by using the economical criterions, we sometimes meet logical contradictions inside the objective functions of minimizing costs and maximizing income profit. And some, when we use two classes of economical criterions, the minimized cost, the best ship is which corresponds to the minimal costs, if the comparable options we consider. And the or second one option, way can be that the best ship is for the maximal profits and the maximal net present value, so is. And is it, do these two approaches have the obstacles? Yes, they have, because if we do the minimization of costs on the regular basis, this corresponds to the minimization of the incomes of your partners. So this is oppression of the economical environment. And finally, not in the interest of the entity which on behalf we decide about the minimization of costs. Because we would, the entity actually are interested in the development of environment as well as a part of his business. That is, the minimization is the oppression of the environment. So is an obstacle of use of the economical criterion like in a minimized cost. The second group of criterion is maximizing profit. Yes, it is. You do not oppress the environment, but if you maximize your profit, finally, you probably make extra expending of the ocean resources. So you can catch so many fish, so is in the interest of your maximal profit. But finally, you will meet the circumstances if no more resources is, and you have the, just only staff like ship, you have assets, but you don't have access to the ocean resources. You spend all the resources. If you use this economical criteria with the maximization of the income on the regular basis. So this is obstacles. And so we have to, when using each of criteria, usually we, second one, have to deduct into the constraint. And if we talk about the minimizing costs, we have to decide that it, in the frameworks that we have to keep the definite level of the income. And if we maximize income, we would decide that about probably the costs have to be like constraint we have. And next, I would like to talk about the construction of these economical models used for development of ship design characteristics. And this person is Professor Karl Ludwig von Bartalanow. He is an Austrian-born biologist, subsequently worked in Vienna, London, Canada, and USA. This person is a professor known as the founder of the systemic approach for development of, in science, systemic approach. He accessed systematically to the research, and he decided that from the systemic approach, we need to develop the constraints, we need to classify the variables in the objective function. Systemic approach in elaboration of the criterion functions for optimization of merchant ship project characteristics. Optimization of the project characteristics using economic criterion is the most logical for complex industrial object. We consider a ship as a complex object, which for each property cannot be considered as a generalized criterion of the variety of all properties, physical, technological, and functional, and so on. We consider a ship as a complex object consisting of many properties, like physical, technological, functional, and so on. But there arises a new property when we combine those many into unit one. There arises new property is economical, because ship is usable as a combination of all other properties. And it makes us possible to use economical criteria. So in accordance with the systemic approach, we consider ship as a complex probabilistic system. Criteria of optimality allowing to separate the optimal project characteristics of or the range of the optimum solution from not optimum are the way to use economic criteria of efficiency, which allows to arrange all compared options of optimized project ship in order of preference. It's as well the systematic approach that we use the criterion functions, and there are two concepts. One concept, what is the criteria of optimality, second one, criteria of efficiency. Is it the same or is it different one criterions? Optimality and efficiency. A different one, because criterion of efficiency is economical indexes allowing to subordinate of all compared options of ships in the sequence of preference. While the criterion of optimality allows to just select which is the best option, not required to ordinate all options in the sequence of their preference. It's important the classification of the characteristics using the economical, using the systemic approach. The criterion is the form of criterion function is defined depending on varied characteristics of projected ship and environment. Variables, we talked a bit about, parameters, the ship particulars or ship subsystem characteristics and data, the constraints in ship project optimization. Each option of project ship is defined by a certain value of this vector of variables x. So, to determine ship optimal characteristics, we need to use the criterion functions. Here we can find the sequence as a sample of what characteristics we use as the usually as x. X is just very formal, and in details the sample can be here that variables can be displacement, dead weight, cargo capacity, tonnage, holds capacity, velocity, power of main engine, so on. It's very important to classify the characteristics for the use in the objective function, the mathematical model of ship. So we have three sets. First, we have to select what is the number of the variables, x. The next, we define that we have to set the constraints. Constraints is the characteristics which we have to set as a constant. Constraints is like constants, characteristics of more general systems, such as we, from systematic point of view, consider ship as a part more general system. More general system can be the shipping company property complex. So ship is part of the shipping company. More general system can be the marine cargo traffic. Ship is a part of marine cargo traffic. Fish can be concerned of the process of fish industrial catching. All these samples is the samples of more general object. And the characteristics of what general object, we say the constraints and use like Z constraints. And the parameters we consider like particulars, ship sizes. We determined in the next, after determination of ship characteristics like displacement, dead weight, cargo capacity, tonnage, power and velocity. In the next, we can determine, on the next step, we can determine sizes. Length, breadth, beam, depth, draft of ship and so on. And constraints we set as previously taken characteristics of more general object. The set of parameters is introduced as a part of those independent values if each of them separately does not impact substantially on the optimality criterion function. On the first step, we decide that probably the parameters like sizes of ship is not so much important. Like a ship, more general size, more general is the characteristic of the displacement, dead weight, cargo, tonnage, and so on. So the rest we use as the parameters, and we say that parameters are conventionally constant. This is two people who involved in the development of systematic approach. The first face shown before was Professor Ludwig van Bartalanafy. He is the professor who entered the systemic approach. He considered all objects of the investigation like a complex system, which consists of subsystems. These two people introduced a systemic approach for development of ships and development of ship projects. We usually consist of ship as a complex object. For example, we can combine ships two parts. One part is ship hull. Ship hull characterizes by, for example, tonnage. And the second part is ship power plant, characterizes by power capacity. When we combine two parts of ship, like main engine and hull together, the new property of ship arises. New property is annual carrying capacity of ship. And this new property is most important for development of the objective function and for optimizing of ship characteristics. And these two people, the left one is Professor Valentin Pashin. He used to be director of scientific center Krylov in St. Petersburg. The right one person is Professor Gennady Demeshko. Gennady Demeshko, professor, I know his personal. He is director of the ship design department of St. Petersburg Maritime State Technical University. And according to system-based concept of project optimization by economic criteria, the project merchant ship methodologically would be defined as a single whole consisting of parts. And when connecting of parts in the whole, the dialectic principle of quantity transition into quality is appeared, and the project ship as a single whole acquires new properties which is absent in the parts of the ships. So if we combine two parts of ship, the hull and the engine into unit one, the new property arises, the ability of ship to carry cargo, which was absent in separate part taken separately. Each part, the ship hull, characterizes by sizes, characterizes by mass, characterized by tonnage, and the second part is main engine. They do not have each separately taken the ability to carry cargo. This new property arises when combining parts in the unit one. And the new property arises when combining parts is most important for development of the project optimizing, which is the main concept of the systemic approach developed. And the subsystems of ship, the parts we combined in the unit one, is not the same as the physical taken. So I did perform the example. Example is that if we combine two parts, ship hull and ship main engine, ship hull characterizes by sizes, by capacity of hold, by tonnage, and ship main engine characterizes by power. We combine and next we got new property of ship, ability to carry cargo. But exactly from the philosophical point of view, from methodological, we do not consider the physical parts of ship combined to the unit one. Because methodologically or philosophically, the parts of ships in each case are not the physical parts, are the separate properties. So philosophically, parts of ship are separate properties which is of the ship as a complex object. As we can say, what is the ship? First explaining is, ship is the combining of the main engine and the hull together. The second explaining could be, ship is combining of the separate properties. Like one property is physical buoyancy, second is stability, next is insubmersibility, and we go so on. And finally, this is the second explaining for this one question, that ship is the combining of the each separate properties. Ship is combining of stability, buoyancy, controllability, hydrodynamics, propulsion, and so on. And if we combine these physical properties, we finally got a ship as a total unit, methodologically, not physically, as a combination of ship, of parts of ship. This is a slide about what is the ship's part from a methodological point of view. And these two people advised to decide about ship as a complex unit combined of separate parts. But parts not taken physically, but taken methodologically, like separate ship properties, which adhere to ships as a total complex unit. And it makes it possible to find a new one property arises when combining parts in the unit one and absent in the separate parts property is the most important for development of the mathematical model of ship and the economical model of optimization of ship characteristics. Use of a systematic approach for ship project characteristic optimization. To determine what is the initial data, it's very important for ship design. We have to set the initial data. We have to set, for example, can be data, the distance between harbors, or distance from the harbor to the district in the ocean of the fishing grounds if we design ship for industrial fish catch. Or can be other classes of the initial data, but what is the initial data in the philosophical, in the methodological aspect. The initial data is the characteristics of more general system. And here on the slide we can find the samples. What can we consider as a more general system than the ships on the project? The more general system can be shipping. Shipping is a process. And shipping we can consider as the asset of shipping company, for example. So the characteristics we set as initial data for ship design optimization using the objective functions. From one point of view, can be characteristics of more general object, which we consider as a shipping company. The second sample of more general object than the ship, which is more important to introduce as the initial data for ship design optimizing, is the shipbuilding industry. Exactly, shipbuilding industry is a more general object than the separate ship, which one is like just output object of shipbuilding industry. The next sample of more general object than the ship could be marine industry. Marine industry is more general object because marine industry consists of two more general objects. One object of marine industry is entity, investor investing money into the access to marine resources using physical assets, using ships. Second object is marine resources, the subject of the interest of the investors. And the third is, So the investor, second, marine resources, the first one is merchant ship. So ship is just an element of the total set of marine industry. And it's important as well as one of the options how to determine the characteristics to set as initial data for determination of ship project characteristics. The last example of more general object here on the slide is the marine engineering. Marine engineering, that is methodologically the concept of ship, belong to marine engineering. Ship is marine engineering, yes, but marine engineering is more general object. It does not cover with just ships only. Besides of ships, there is many objects of marine engineering. In this class of the objects of methodologically marine engineering is the more general object of the ship as a subject of design. This makes us possible to develop hierarchy of economical models of ship. Hierarchy allows us to define what is the initial data for ship optimizing. The initial data is the characteristics search as a decision of more general task in the hierarchical aspect, then more general than the task of ship optimizing itself. And this is a picture which shows us the relations between the levels of optimization tasks. Because to make a very systematic and scientific and materialistic the optimizing determination of shape characteristics, we need to determine the classification of the variables in the objective function. So we use the economical criteria as a function on x, y, z, on the arguments. These arguments we have to use as independent data. And we need to classify which one of the independent data are the variables. The variables is the independent characteristic of shapes, which imply the most degree on the objective function. Second, we have to define what is the particulars or parameters. Particles or parameters are the characteristics of shape subsystems, of shape equipment, or characteristics of shape in general on the next step when we do develop details of shape, like develop details of shape structure of the hull, maybe framing, sides, and so on, structure of the hull of the ship. And what is the initial data? So very important to know what is Z. Z is initial data. And initial data is characteristic of more general system than is the ship. And here we, on the picture, can see the two levels of design optimizing. The first level, the left one, is optimizing of the upper level, which is the more general characteristics than the ship. This a company which have the access to the marine resources. And the right one is the characteristic is how to determine particulars. And the middle one part of the picture is the transforming of the characteristics from the upper level task to the bottom level. These characteristics got by using the economical criteria in the constraints used for the upper level task for optimizing of ship. This is a commercial vessel characteristics optimization. And when we have that, we finally, in the next can got the particulars like sizes of ship, using the physical properties of ship, such as buoyancy, stability, hydrodynamics, controllability, and mechanical properties of ship hull, like endurance and so on. And what we talk about is the concept of the comparability of options of ship, options of compared to make a choice of the best characteristic of ship. We compare options, all they are with the same initial data Z. The initial data characteristic of general system for all the options are resemble. And this is the concept of the comparability of the project characteristics of ship is the resemblance of more general object for the same options compared to the definite level. Besides, while going through the steps from design of ship characteristics to particles, so some of the variables change the position in the classes. Originally, it used to be like a characteristic of ship. In the next, when determining the parts of ship project, like ship equipment and just any of structures of ship separate. So use the characteristic of the previous taken one level to in the next as initial data for determination of particulars on the bottom level tasks. And here is some practical recommendations how to determine the set of the characteristics to make objective function. Here is just a sequence of the practical recommendations and the conclusions. Conclusions. First is the design process of merchant ship generally concludes in the determining of the optimal project characteristics. Here is a sample of set of the project characteristics search by optimizing and project particulars. And here we have the set as well, like length, beam, depth, block coefficient, draft, all proportions. This is the most important step of creation of merchant ship, as many of decisions that have an impact on the following steps of ship construction and operation may be undertaken in the best economic performance in the ship designing. Second, conclusion. While the determining of the particulars of projected ship, like sizes of ship, for example, here in the second point, which are necessary for development of drawings of the ship and the documentary for ship construction are applied, the mathematical models of physical properties of ship. So in the next steps, we do not use economical approaches, but we can use physical. And the characteristics of project the ship, we use as initial data for using of physical properties of ship to determine its sizes. This was point two. Point three, the project ship characteristics of such as displacement, dead weight, cargo, tonnage, and so on, can be determined or with the prototypes as did before, or using the approaches of design optimization as we advise it to do, using the economical criterions and systemic approach of the comparability of options. Four, for the design of new ships in accordance with the economic conditions and with the market demand, it's logical to use the methods of design optimization, not data prototype, because data of ship prototype is obsolete. Obsolete, and for ship of new types, it can be practically available along the usable, analogs usable in the design. It's understandable. And five, for project optimization of the merchant ship, I use the criterion objective functions, like dependence of criterion function, various classes of criterion function, like criterions of costs minimized, like criterions of their incomes, or adhere to incomes, criterions of profits, so on. Independence on independent variables, parameters, and data, which is characteristics of ship and more general system and more detailed systems than the ship. Six, for project optimization of ship can be used the economical criteria. Here are two samples. First criteria based on the minimized cost concepts. Second is a sample of maximized index of income or profit. And when using these two concepts of the economical criterions and the objective functions subsequently, we can meet two obstacles. And the obstacles is like we do not evaluate the financial ability of investor. This is entity investing, investor entity investing in ship construction. We do not evaluate the marine resources used corresponding to the limiting characteristic of income. Maybe there is quota for catching of ocean biological resources, SOAS. Seven, economically, the marine resources while optimizing the projected ship are defined not only as a physical aquatic environment, but as a sea-like a complex concept, including the following. We consider marine resources not physically, like water resources, not biologically, like biological resources, not the oil from the or deposits from the seabed, but we methodologically consider the marine resources like a philosophical concept which consists of any properties of the ocean environment available to use economically, and this can be the characteristics of sea, geographical location, climatic conditions, biological resources, mineral resources of seabed, industrial potential of the coast. So any kinds of the marine environment we can consider as marine resources from the economical point of view. Eight, to create the economical model for project optimizing of ship, the logical classification of the indexes contained in the model for ship project optimization is of the great importance. So we can very logically determine what is initial data, what is variables, what is parameters of particulars of ship. Nine, systemic approach is used for logical classification of indexes contained in the model for ship project optimizing. Project ship is considered methodologically as complex system consisting of subsystems. We consist ship of subsystems, which makes us possible to determine what is ship characteristics, what is characteristics of subsystems, and what is more general system than the ship, which characteristic is initial data for ship optimizing. 10. The list of samples of the more general objects than the merchant ship could be shipping. Project ship belongs to property complex of shipping company. Second, shipbuilding industry. Third, marine industry. Like ship is element of marine industry, of the access of investor to the marine resources. Two other elements of marine industry, marine resources, investor, and ship itself. Next, marine engineering. The ship methodologically is just marine engineering, but marine engineering another object, not only the ship itself. Concept of a general object is very important to determine systematically the initial data for project optimization of ship. What is initial data? We need to know what is a more general system. If we know, we can determine systematically what is initial data for optimizing of ship characteristics. 11. For the projected ship of new classes and innovative assignments, which for could not be appropriate analogies for use in the design process, the more general object can be considered to meet sets of the special requirements depending on the characteristics of the devices and the equipment for special assignments planned to be installed on ship if the equipment had been created beforehand to be installed on board. So as For some classes of ship, such as icebreaker for nuclear power icebreaker, we first need to create a power plant, because there is not a nuclear power plant of the required power of nowadays technology. So the separate devices of ship, sometimes we can consider as a more general object, because is initial data. First we create the subsystem of ship. It can be equipment for cargo transportation for liquefied natural gas. For example, the of nowadays achievements of shipbuilding industry is the development of very big ships for transportation of liquefied natural gas. And the equipment of transportation can be like initial data for designation of ship characteristics itself. So not only the more general system can we consider as initial data of determination for a ship, but as well sometimes we can consider a part of ship designed before, usually if the part of ship is of nowadays achievements of shipbuilding industry. And to the examples of merchant ships whose design can start from this separate equipment, we can add here the tankers transportation of liquefied natural gas is the number 12 of new classes. The icebreakers, which construction and design are largely linked to the creation of power plants specifically for this class of ships, and the ships of the various classes for navigation in Arctic seas, which design is subject for the requirements of navigation in ice. So we need to set as a more general characteristic the required thickness of ice available for ice going ship to force in this way. So I'm thank you for attention, for your patience. And if some of you is interested in more detail, you can find here the electronic address on this slide. And this electronic address you can use and you can access to the electronic book. This electronic book, I can show you sample, not electronic one, but this is a book about use of economical approaches for the determination of ship characteristics. This is a book published, available for free online. You can access this address. There are books in two languages. One language is English, another one Russian. Book published in two languages, physical is this English language book. And in Russian language book published today available in United States Congress Library 2, in Russian language only. In English language, it's here in the library of our university. So I'm very thankful you for your patience and attention. If you have some questions in later, please ask me after, maybe not now, maybe you need some time to decide about that. And as I presented on behalf of two persons, my presentation today, my speech on behalf of mine and my alt-author, I mean Professor Sergei Agai. It takes a long time, but it is behalf of two people, two presentations in the unit one. And besides, we hadn't now one person who decided originally to be presentation, Dr. Chris Rath, we have not, unfortunately. So as I understand about it, we have today one presentation, maybe I don't know, is a person here, title Environmental Issues, the second one presentation, Environmental Issues Surround Sewage and Food Waste of Mr. Niklas Carlson. Do we have Mr. Niklas Carlson here? What time is now? Is 10?
12.
No Niklas Carlson here? Okay, if not person, not as a person, it was only my presentation, not Mr. Sergei Agai, Professor Sergei Agai. So thank you very much for your attention. If you will have the questions, that is, now we have coffee break. And after coffee break, we have the presentation of Dr. Tetsuya Hiraishi. After coffee break, it will be at 10:55.
Yeah, I see.
Yes?
Yes.
So thank you very much for your attention, for your patience. If you have any questions about determination of ship characteristics, I am very welcome to answer your questions if you will have.
One question that I have. Mm-hmm. You are the method to optimize the type of fish, type of a vessel is available to the very large vessel like a tanker and like a very big cargo ships. You are mentioned about the fish and the ferry boat, the middle class. But the optimal method is available for large, very large tankers. Is it right?
Yeah, thank you very much for your question. Yes, I believe I understand your question. And this is conceptually. You talk about like that.
Size of the ships.
Mm-hmm. If you make a design of ship, usually you have the data. So is very characteristic for Japan. Mm-hmm. Is fish catching nearby the harbors.
Yeah.
And there is very close extent from harbor to fish catch district. Very close, maybe, I don't know, 10 hours to go to the catch district.
Yes.
And if you set in the mathematical model, this using mathematical model, if you set the distance to from harbor to the fishing catching ground, it's very close.
Yes, yes.
You obtain small size ship.
Ah, I see.
It depends on the data. It depends on data set. So as you use this equation, for example, it is the same as here on the picture.
I see.
The previous one is example. In this mathematical equation, we have the data like LR.
Ah,
LR okay. is the distance between harbor and the district of fish catch.
Ah, I see.
Yes, and if you go to the detail, you can take only all this equation, like here. You can develop for the small size boat.
Ah, yeah.
But you first have to decide which is more important. You want to catch fish for the small expenses.
I see.
Or you would like to catch fish for the maximal profit. Is another point of view.
Yes.
If you need to maximal profit,
yes.
you need to have big ship.
I see.
If you economical, logical people,
yeah.
so you build a small one to catch close to the coast.
Yeah. I see.
So thank you very much for your question.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you for questions, and maybe if no any questions, we have a coffee break.
Yeah.